Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You're watching Full Take. So last time we reviewed one of the most hyper and highly customizable ROM, Infinity X 2.7. you can check that video from the icard link. Infinity X team recently released their another update of Infinity X 2.8 for all official devices, and we also got this custom GSI build. This time we booted this on our two devices. One is oneplus 9rt and another one is poco x2. Yes, Poco X2, our forgotten device. Actually, because of some issues, Poco X2 was not working well, but after installation of this new build, it's completely revived from the dead condition. That's why I always encourage my viewers to take some knowledge about custom ROMs and modding on Android devices, which will give your old Android device a new life. So today in this video, we are going to review all the new changes of Infinity X2.8, including its source base, new features, and at the last we shown all the bugs and issues of Infinity X 2.8 GSI build. So users who are already using Infinity X 2.7 will get idea what has been changed and new features they received in the new update, while viewers who want to try the GSI build will get idea does it really make sense to try and use this build on their devices or not. So watch this video till the end. Now without further delay, let's get started. I booted Infinity X2.8 custom GSI on OnePlus 9RT and Poco X2. We will check about device details and the changes and the bugs for both of these devices which are running with the same build. But I will show you the detailed change log and the new features of this build only on OnePlus 9RT because they are same for both devices. If you check the about device details on OnePlus 9RT, it's showing the device name as OnePlus 12R. This is because this GSI is ported for all Android devices from the official Infinity X custom ROM of OnePlus 12R device. As this is a GSI build, it's showing the unofficial version of Infinity X 2.8 build. This is the same Android 15 build ported by the amazing developer PapaQ. Security patches are updated with the latest May 2025 for 9RT. This ROM is based on the kernel version 5.4.254, which is built with the Clang toolchain 11. Build date of this GSI build is of 8 May 2025. If you check details of this GSI on Poco X2, everything remains same. I only got the changes for the kernel version for Poco X2. It has a base of 4.14.350 kernel, which is built with the Clang toolchain 17. Now we'll thoroughly discuss all the changes done by the Infinity X team for 2.8 version. If you want to check all detailed feature review, please check our old video. First team has added the pin or lock shortcut for recents application. If you use this feature by long pressing on the recents application and lock application, it will remain in the memory even after we clear all application until we unlock or unpin it from the recents tab. Next, for recents panel, team has added the new Oxonos-like rounded icon shapes for clear all, screenshot, and Google Lens tabs, which looks cool. In the QoS panel, new private DNS style has been added, so you can enable the private DNS by just single click by using this style without going deep in a settings panel. Next, for the settings panel, team has added the new icons. Beyond this, you can customize this icon as you want by using the settings icon customization feature. This feature is available in the Infinity suite and under the themes tab option. This offers the wide range of icon styles for settings panel via icon style option. There are a bunch of the different styles available here. All of them gives completely different look for your device settings panel. Even we can change the shape of these icons to round and square one using the corner style option. Random color toggle gives the multiple colors to all setting icons, so they will look more colorful. Next, for Infinity X launcher, developer has added background opacity control slider for app drawer. By using this, you can give the complete transparent, partially transparent, or solid look to app drawer by using this setting. Similarly, we get same background opacity control for recent task manager. Both of these settings gives some glass-like effect for app drawer and recent task panel. In the home setting of the launcher, for a hot seat background of the dock application, we got the same background opacity control slider, which gives the glass-like effect to the dock application. Even the look of this hot seat background is also more refined with the new rounded corners with this new update. In the Infinity X suit and under the notification, now gets the new option of transparent notification, which gives full transparent look to all notifications. But to make it work, you need to set the QS panel transparency in the QS panel setting as per your requirement for the better look. For game space application, which is available in the app drawer, team has added the new options to improve the quick start of games like launch boost, smart memory management, loading priority, cache management, etc. All of this helps you to load heavy games like BGMI, Modern Combat much faster than previous build. Even by using the quick start application option, we can improve the opening speed of gaming and non-gaming application. In the miscellaneous setting of the Infinity X suit, we got the new vibrate on the scroll frame toggle, which enables the vibration feedback when you reach to the end or the top of the settings pages everywhere in the system or the app setting. This will give the amazing haptic feedback. In the QS panel setting of the Infinity X suit, team has added the new QS page transition animations. Here you get a bunch of the different transition animation, which gives amazing look while switching between the QS panel pages. I especially liked the cube in and cube out animation. This will give the 3D-like effect for the QS panel pages. These are all the new changes we discussed, but there are lots of amazing features are available in Infinity X that we already discussed in our old Infinity X 2.7 video. You must watch that video, its link is given in the video description. All of them are working for both of my devices with this new GSI build. So main question most of you will ask, does GSI really work to use? What are its bugs and what's working? So for my Poco X2 and OnePlus 9RT, all major functions are working. Especially basic and device integrity checks got successful for both of these devices, which is essential for working of all security and banking applications. Surprisingly, DRM info showing the security level as L1, so you can stream Netflix and Amazon Prime with the full HD resolution. Even Google Play Protect is certified for both of these devices. This is all happening because of new bootloader lock spoofing, which is integrated by a developer in this new generation custom ROMs. Like old Infinity X 2.7, for my OnePlus 9RT, I am facing no fingerprint sensor is available, but you can use face unlock as alternative option. Surprisingly, Poco X2 has working fingerprint setting and even fingerprint sensor is working perfectly for this device. For 9RT, OnePlus alert slider is not working. I also got another shock because of Poco X2 have properly working punch hole camera notch for status bar by default. While for my 9RT, showing the misalignment for the camera punch hole and status bar icons. That can be easily solved by using the punch hole cutout option available in the display and under the display cutout option. But bug of 2G calling is same for both of these devices. Though the 4G and 5G internet is working, but when you make a call, calling will switch on the 2G network. So we did not get the VoLT or VoNR calling in the GSI build. Soon I will release the separate video to solve these issues and other minor bugs. In OnePlus 9RT, default phone application causing force close whenever you make a call, but you can use any third party application from the Play Store and set it as a default phone application, then this issue will get solved. Surprisingly, on Poco X2, default phone application and dialer working well without any issue. It seems that Poco X2 have more stable experience on Infinity X GSI, while OnePlus 9RT giving me minor bugs like all GSI tried till the date. So we can conclude that GSI will give different bugs for different devices, while custom ROM users will not face such major issues. This is all about for today guys, hope you liked our work, then please do like and share this video, subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming detailed review of custom ROM, GSI build and amazing mods for all Android devices. Thanks for watching, see you next time, take care, bye bye.